The challenge for us is how to articulate very clearly the climate value proposition for the world, as well as the economic value proposition.
We as Africans have the solution. It's the private sector who have to invest in green economy, blue economy, renewable energy by empowering our African private sector.
Until now, with climate finance, most of the time Africa is borrowing the funds, affecting its balance sheet, taking away borrowing capacity to develop other sectors, to put it on something that is good for Africa, yes, but good for humanity. Africa believes that it needs more concessional money and more grant resources to make sure that Africa is playing its fair share, but also paying only the fair burden.
I strongly believe in personal entrepreneurship, in PPA or PPP that will really bring private and public money together to actually accelerate the pace at which we are going to deploy renewable energy in Africa.
We want to change the narrative. African financial institutions can take the help and prove the business case of adaptation finance, help package a pipeline of adaptation projects in food and water.
Project preparation is as important as investment. Let's have the African countries are also organizing themselves in the way they can actually have bankable project by the time the funding is available, so we can be investing these billions of dollars into bankable project.
If a project is well constructed, that the business model makes sense, the financing will follow, because when you're looking at the international markets, of course everybody believes that there's a lot of potential in Africa to do ventures, whether it is in the energy, whether it is in other sectors. So there is a potential, there is interest, but now you need projects that are concrete, and that's why we're working on that from the private sector angle.
I think in terms of risk that can be anticipated, can be mitigated. So it's really important to build that culture within the public policy discourse of many African countries, because managing is anticipating and governing is also anticipating, and I hope the African governments understand and appreciate it, and that's why we're here, to support them.
It is at the end private capital that is going to make the difference. So that needs to be in place first and foremost. Being willing to take risk, offtake risk, credit risk, and help private capital making those investments in renewable energy in Africa. I think that is going to be key to drive that development.
It's inexcusable that Africa gets 0.6% of global investment in renewable energy when it has some of the best renewable energy potential of any place in the world. And we need to now move into, one, putting the projects on the table that can attract investment, but then capital has to do its part and say, this is the cheapest green energy anywhere in the world if we invest in it.